He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay, so let's go through a problem regarding balancing equations. So here are four equations that we're going to need to balance. If you'll notice, they are not currently balanced. And so this is pretty straightforward. There's nothing much more to say. If you need any help with this concept and some strategies that you can use in order to do this, check out my tutorial on balancing equations. Otherwise, when you're ready, go ahead and give these a try. So let's start with this first one. We have CaCl2 plus Na3PO4 yields Ca3PO42 plus NaCl. So if you have trouble with these and you want to be very, very thorough in your approach, the best way is to make a table like this where we've listed every element that is involved in the reaction, and then we can tally the number of atoms of each element on the left side and on the right side. So let's go ahead and do that now. We have got one calcium atom on the left and three calcium atoms on the right. For chlorine, we have two on the left because we have Cl2, and on the right we have just one in NaCl. For sodium, we have three on the left and we have one on the right. For phosphorus, we have one on the left and then we have two on the right. Don't forget that with PO4 in parentheses, then we have the two outside of the parentheses. That means there are two phosphate polyatomic ions. So it's PO4 twice. That means we have PO4 and another PO4. So that's two phosphorus atoms. And then for oxygen, same thing. On the left, we have four. On the right, we actually have eight because we have O4, but PO4 is twice. So we have O4 and another O4. That's eight. That's eight oxygen atoms. So that's the number of atoms of each element that we have on each side. And now all of those need to be balanced. So where shall we start? Let's just go ahead and start with calcium. So all we need is a coefficient to the left of some substance to balance the number of atoms of that particular element to get the same number on each side. So for calcium, we have one on the left and three on the right. So the easiest thing to do will be to put a three right here. So now we have CaCl2, but that coefficient of three means we have three of those. So we have CaCl2, CaCl2, and another CaCl2. So that means we have one calcium for each of those, so we have three calcium atoms total. So let's change our tally for calcium on the left side to three. So calcium is now balanced. We have three on the left and three on the right. So that's done. But what we must realize is that we also have made it so that there are six chlorine atoms on the left because we have Cl2, but we have three of those. So two chlorine atoms per formula unit times three of those means there are six chlorine atoms on the left now. So what shall we do next? So we'll come back to chlorine. But what we want to understand is that there's a simpler way to do this than to do phosphorus and oxygen separately, because phosphorus and oxygen are involved in the phosphate ion. It's a polyatomic ion, and those are not going to get split up. They remain together, so we can actually balance the entire phosphate ion at the same time. So we take a look at the left, we have a PO4, and then on the right we have PO42. So we can treat that as though it's an individual thing. We can just try to get the same number of phosphate ions on both sides. So as we said, we have two phosphate ions on the right. So if we put a two here, that means we are going to have two phosphate ions on the left. And now look at what we've done. We have made it so that there are two phosphorus atoms on the left and eight oxygen atoms on the left. Because we have Na3PO4, we have two of those. So all of those are multiplied by two, and now both phosphorus and oxygen are balanced. However, we have also altered the number of sodium atoms on the left side because we have Na3 and we've multiplied that by two. So we need to change the number of sodium atoms on the left side to six. So what should we do next? Well, as it turns out, we can go ahead and take care of both chlorine and sodium at the same time, because on the right we have NaCl. It looks like we need to put a 6 here, because we have 6 sodiums on the left and 6 chlorines on the left, and only one of each on the right. So if we put a 6 there, we are going to change the number of sodium and chlorine atoms on the right, both to 6. And so that is going to balance both of those elements, and that will actually completely balance the equation. So those are the coefficients in the balanced equation for this reaction. Okay, let's look at the next one. We have a combustion reaction. We have C2H6O plus O2 yields CO2 plus H2O. So let's make our table. It's a little bit smaller. All we have is carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. So let's make our initial tally. For carbon, we have 2 carbon atoms on the left and 1 carbon atom on the right. For hydrogen, we have 6 atoms on the left and we have 2 on the right. And for oxygen, we have 3 on the left because we have 1 oxygen atom in C2H6O and we have an O2 molecule. And then on the right, we have also 3 because we have O2 in the CO2 and we have 1 oxygen atom in water. So that is our initial tally. So where should we start? Well, here is one handy tip. Anytime you have some element that is by itself in a particular species, you want to do that one last because you have the most freedom with that one. You can get everything else balanced and then you can just put whatever coefficient you want for that element to make it work without affecting the numbers for any other element. So we are going to do oxygen last, also because currently it is balanced, so we're going to have to mess with the other two elements first. But in general, if you see O2 or N2 or H2, you can feel free to do that one last. So why don't we start with carbon? We have 2 on the left and 1 on the right. So what we need to do is put a 2 next to CO2 so that we have 2 carbon atoms on the right. So now carbon is balanced. However, we have also changed the number of oxygen atoms on the right. We have 4 from CO2 because we have 2 CO2s. So there's a CO2 and another CO2. Each of those has 2 oxygen atoms, so that's 4 oxygen atoms from CO2 plus the 1 from water, and that gives us 5 oxygen atoms on the right. Now let's balance hydrogen. We have 6 on the left and we have 2 on the right, so we need to put a 3 next to water because that is going to give us 3 water molecules, each of which has 2 hydrogen atoms. That gives us a total of 6 hydrogen atoms on the right, and that will balance hydrogen. However, we have also again changed the number of oxygen atoms because we now have 4 from CO2 plus 3 from water because we have 3 waters, for a total of 7 oxygen atoms on the right. So lastly, we can balance oxygen. Now we have 7 on the right. And on the left, we have 1 from C2H6O, and we're probably not going to want to mess with that because that will alter the number of carbons and hydrogens. And so what we want to do is manipulate O2. So if we need to get 7 on the left, and one of them is in C2H6O, that leaves a total of 6 that we need from O2. Now, luckily, that's going to be very easy to do because all we have to do is put a 3 here, and now we have 3 O2 molecules, so an O2, an O2, and another O2, and that adds up to 6 oxygen atoms. So the 6 oxygens from O2 plus the other one gives us 7 on the left. And now oxygen is balanced, and the equation is balanced in general. Let's move on to our third example. We have CO plus H2 yields C8H18 plus H2O. So let's make our table again. Once again, we just have C, H, and O. So let's make our tally. Carbon, we've got 1 carbon atom on the left, and we have 8 carbon atoms on the right, from C8. For hydrogen, we have just 2 on the left, and on the right, we have 20 because we have H18 and we have H2 from water. So 18 plus 2 is 20. And then for oxygen, we have just the one from CO and the one from H2O. So once again, remember that last trick that we learned. If we have one element that's by itself, we want to do that one last. And in this case, that's hydrogen. So we want to save hydrogen for last. Now, oxygen happens to be balanced at the moment, so let's start with carbon. For carbon, we've got 8 carbon atoms on the right, and we have just one on the left. So we're going to need to put an 8 here so that we have 8 CO molecules, and therefore 8 carbon atoms on the left. And now carbon is balanced. However, we have also altered the number of oxygen atoms on the left side. We now have 8 of those. So now let's go ahead and balance oxygen since we have disrupted that balance. We have 8 on the left and we have 1 on the right. So let's put an 8 here. And now we have 8 oxygen atoms on both sides and oxygen is balanced. Now let's do hydrogen. On the right side, we have 18 from C8H18 and we have 16 from water because we have 2 hydrogen atoms in each water molecule times 8 water molecules. And 18 plus 16 is 34. So we have 34 on the right side, but this is the easy part because on the left we have H2 by itself. So all we have to do is put a coefficient next to H2 that will make this balanced and it won't affect any other element. So 34 divided by 2 is 17. That means we need 17 H2 molecules. That will give us 34 hydrogen atoms on the left. And hydrogen is now balanced, and the equation is balanced. Okay, one more. NH4NO3 yields N2 plus O2 plus H2O. Once again, we make our table. This time it has N, H, and O. For nitrogen, we have 2 on the left and 2 on the right. For hydrogen, we have 4 on the left and 2 on the right. And for oxygen, we have 3 on the left and 3 on the right. So it seems that everything is balanced except hydrogen. So let's go ahead and work with that first. We have 4 on the left and 2 on the right. So we need to put a 2 next to water because 2 water molecules will yield 4 hydrogen atoms. So now we have 4 on the right and hydrogen is balanced. However, we have changed the number of oxygen atoms on the right. We have 2 from O2, and now we have 2 from water, 1 per water molecule and 2 water molecules. So now we have 4 oxygen atoms on the right. So let's go ahead and balance oxygen. Now here's where it gets a little bit trickier, because we have 4 on the right and we have 3 on the left. So there's nothing we can immediately do to balance it. But we know that we have more oxygen on the right than we do on the left, and we only have one thing on the left that we can work with. So let's just go ahead and put a 2 here, because we need more oxygen on the left. But this is the best we can do. So let's just put a 2 here, and that will give us 6 oxygen atoms on the left. So now we have something to work with. On the right, we can do some things to balance oxygen a little bit later. But we needed to do that to get more oxygen on the left. However, we have now changed some other things. We now have 8 hydrogen atoms on the left. So unfortunately, hydrogen is no longer balanced. We also have 4 nitrogen atoms on the left now because each of those has 2 nitrogen atoms and now we have 2 of them. So we have 4 nitrogen atoms on the left. So now let's start balancing again. Let's go to oxygen one more time. We have 6 on the left and we have 4 on the right. So what is one way that we could get 2 more oxygen atoms? Well, we have oxygen in water. So to get 2 more oxygens, we could just have 2 more waters. So let's change this to 4 waters. And that gives us 6 oxygen atoms on the right. So oxygen is balanced. It also gives us 8 hydrogen atoms on the right, which means that hydrogen is also balanced. So that was a good step. Lastly, we just need to do nitrogen. Luckily, nitrogen is by itself on the right side. So to get four nitrogen atoms on the right side, we just put a 2 here so that we have 2N2. That gives us 4 nitrogens on the right. So now nitrogen is balanced and the equation is balanced.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.